Thank you, Louisville Adventist Academy Ladies Trio. Age to age, you're still the same by the power of your name, El Shaddai. Anybody know what that ancient name for God means, El Shaddai? God Almighty, God All-Powerful. And as it says in Jeremiah 10, verse 12, but the Lord made the earth by his power. He preserves it by his wisdom. With his own understanding, he stretched out the heavens. Again, that's Jeremiah 10, verse 12. And that's going to be the focus and the theme of our Sabbath school this morning, is looking and reminding ourselves how God made the earth with his power, and he also preserves it by his wisdom. Amen? Going to be looking at, of course, the 7 days of creation. And the 7 days of creation, especially in the ancient Hebrew mind, represented the seven perfect characteristics of God. So let's start with day one. What did God create on day one? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Day one, he created, let there be. There you go. Very good. They get it. He created light. Light represents, especially in the ancient Hebrew mindset, any guesses what light represents? Yes. You. What does light represent?
For the light of shininess.
The light of shininess. Exactly. He got it. And you know, aren't you glad that we have some light and we have bright students like this young man? Well, light represents a lot of things, but in this context, light represents kindness. Kindness. The bright light of God's kindness shines on everyone. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 5:45 that God causes his son, the light of his son, to rise on the evil and the good. That's because he is kind. Let's go to day two. It's quiz time. What did God create on day two? These seem to be sharp Bible scholars. Day two, what did God create? Air. Okay, very good. Very good. That's a very simple answer. I appreciate that. Yes, he, as the Bible put it, he put a separation between the waters and the sky, which apparently before he did that, there was just water. So yeah, exactly. He created air. So God is kind, yes, but you know, creating a separation, you have to make a judgment call when you start separating and organizing things. So although God is kind, that's balanced by his righteous judgment. God's kindness balanced by his judgment. Okay, day three, what did God create on day three? What's that? Yes. Land, very good. Y'all are showing the academy kids up. They're learning a lot today from you youngsters. Very good, I like that. Yes, he created land. Let the land produce all kinds of plants and vegetations. This is day three. So this is especially appropriate for music festival and for our upcoming choir. The land producing all kinds of plants and vegetation. This represents the characteristic of God in that God produces beauty through things working together, or God creates beauty through harmony, just like we're going to experience all weekend long. Beauty through harmony. Well, speaking of beauty through harmony, I want to invite up Greenville Adventist Academy. You may not know this, but I am an alumnus of Greenville Adventist Academy. I went to 7th and 8th grade there. So, GAA is going to share two numbers with us. Come on up, Greenville. Greenville, Tennessee, that is. You're supposed to say amen, but I'm going to say wow. That was good. You know, I was talking to you about harmony, and I had no idea we were going to hear that kind of harmony this morning. That was fantastic. Thank you, Greenville. Well, speaking of harmony, we are up now to day number 4 of creation. I know you know elementary school. Let's see what the academy knows. And I'm the Bible teacher, so if they don't know, you understand it reflects poorly on me. Bible scholars, what did God create on day 4? The sun, moon, and stars. You knew that was coming up and you Googled it real quick, didn't you? You're smart. I taught you well. Amen. The sun, moon, and stars, who, of course, also work in harmony together as you see God laying the groundwork for the ecosystem of our universe that he created. And you also see a kind of a chiasm going on here. In other words, God created the sun and the moon and the stars to support his kindness. In other words, to help reflect the light of his kindness being reproduced and redistributed, reflected. God sharing his light to sustain and produce more growth here on the earth. And think about it. Even when the sun sets, it's replaced by the light of the moon. And then there's the hope and the knowledge and the trust and the faith that the sun will rise again. And as the Bible says, even though weeping may endure for a night, what comes in the morning? Joy, a joy of the kindness of the light of God's sunrise rising every morning. Day number 5. What did God create on day number 5? Yes. Oh, you forgot. Okay. How about you? Day 5.
The bird and the fish.
Say it again. The birds and the fish. Does that sound right? Thank you, young man. Very good. Exactly. Sea creatures, birds filling the skies. And this, of course, is also supporting the balancing act of God's judgment. God's judgments are good, and he's creating space. He created space for this life and activity to take place in his creation. Birds and fish filling the skies and the waters. Well, with that in mind, let's fill this platform once again with, I believe, Greenville Adventist Academy, this time the band. Come and share with us and inspire us and bless us again with your music. Thank you again, Greenville Adventist Academy. And of course, I don't know if you all know this. Of course, this is, what do we call this music festival? The Kentucky, Tennessee, yeah, very good. Music festival, and Greenville's actually not part of the conference. But, they're in charge of government. But, they're in Tennessee, amen? And this is the Kentucky, Tennessee Music Festival. And my point is, you can see why we invite them every year. Fantastic. Greenville, again, thank you so much. That, the song they just played, anybody know what that's called? Joyful, joyful, we adore thee. And did you also know that that is actually the tune of at least what used to be Germany's national anthem, Deutschland über alles? And my dad, who took great pride in his German heritage, whenever this was being played in church, he would make me stand with him. I'm going to stand. But going with our creation, thank you all for playing that. Going with our creation theme, let me remind you of some of the lyrics of that song that we just heard so beautifully played by the band. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee. Hail thee as the sun above. This is my prayer for today. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness. Drive the dark of doubt away. Amen. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light, the kindness, the light of day. Amen. Thank you again. We are up to day 6 of creation. And on day 6, what did God create? I heard some mumbling. People, Adam and Eve, there's something before that. Animals, yay, very good. Thank you. Notice, yes, God formed life, bringing life, animals, little creatures. And then he says this. Let us make humans in our own image. So God, what has he been doing all week? He's been working. Okay, good. What else? Specifically, creating. And then he says, let's make humans, mankind, to also be creators, right? Let's make them in our own image. And so he makes us. We are made to be creative, which we are celebrating the creativity of music this weekend. Amen. God forming life from the foundation of the earth. And that reminds us that Jesus, as 1 Corinthians 3:11 says, Jesus is our firm foundation. He creates man from the foundation of the earth, from the dirt of the earth. Absolutely. And then God rested. He was done creating, right? And he called it good. He looked at his creation. He called it good. Let me put a little segue in here. Psalm 104, 31 through 34. David was inspired to celebrate God's creative power. He says, this is again Psalm 104, 31 through 34. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks at the earth and it trembles. He touches the hills and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. Amen. Music festival. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing the praises of my God while I have my being. May my meditation be sweet to him. I will be glad in the Lord. And that, of course, brings us to us meditating on God's creation, which he designed for us to do as he did on that very first Sabbath. On the seventh day, what did God do? He rested. Amen. And he created what we know as today as the Sabbath. Rested from all his work. Isn't it nice to take a rest? And you're like, well, amen, we had to get up early, we had to come to church. And, you know, I was at a chaplain's, the first ever, at least in recent memory, the first ever Southern Union's chapel retreat. Met a great group of people there. We were talking about life as a chaplain, and you know, it's not for me, but they were saying how busy they are, and oh, you know, you have to, even on Sabbath. And I was like, you know what, Sabbath is my favorite day, not because I necessarily don't, you know, I rest or anything. As I get up and I get my guitar going, and I try to get the kids even earlier. I get Sophia out there and try to get, because so we can practice and get our praise on, because I love it. It's not work. If you enjoy what you do, you don't work a day in your life. I feel rather lazy because I love what I do. And especially on a day like today, where we can just rest and bask in God's goodness and sing his praises, it's a good day. And it is. It's a day of rest because we're doing something a little different. So sure enough, God rested from his work, and he rested, and he blessed the Sabbath day, and he hallowed it. But this idea of rest, it's something very symbolic for us as well. Because as the writer of Hebrews said in Hebrews 4:10, for all who have entered into God's rest, have you entered into God's rest? For all who have entered into God's rest, we have rested from our labors, just as God did after creating the world. Jesus is our Sabbath rest. And in a world where we talk so much today about stress and anxiety and all these kind of things, enter into the rest of Jesus. Find your peace in him. Just say, you know what? God's got this. And find that rest every day. Having said that, let us now hear from, you know, I love Greenville. I'm an alumnus, but, you know, I'm partial to this next group, Highland Elementary School. They're a bright group. They've had all the right answers this morning. Now let's listen to them as they sing some songs for us.
Thank you. invite you to sing one more song with us. We've been sitting a long time. Let's stand up together and sing this last song together. It's number 565 in your hymnal, For the Beauty of the Earth. And again, just like before, we will sing just one verse.
Thank you.
Thank you, Highland Academy Choir. Amen. Well, we ended on day 7, and we end there because it's the 7 days of creation. But yet, what comes after 7? 8. Well, 1, 8. Yeah, okay. Let's go with 8, because we talk about the significance of the number 7, which is symbolic of... What's 7 symbolic of? Rest, but also wholeness, completion, perfection. Very good. So when after 7 comes 8, and after you've completed something, like God was done creating the earth and creating the rest of the Sabbath, what comes after that? 8. So what does 8 symbolize? Pastor Steve, a new beginning. And think about the way that 8 is shaped. If you turn it on its side, what is that the symbol of? Infinity. Yeah, we are just, and God has put eternity in all of our hearts. And by the way, that's why a Jewish child was circumcised on the 8th day. It symbolized a new beginning. That's why 8 people started the earth over from the ark. That's why King David was the 8th son, and he was starting a new dynasty. The number 8 symbolizes a new beginning. So as we celebrate creation, and we celebrate the rest of God's Sabbath, we can also celebrate a new beginning. Thank you all so much for being here for Sabbath School. Let's have a closing word of prayer, take a break, and then we will come back for the divine service. Heavenly Father, God, we thank you for your creation, which we have celebrated this morning. God, we thank you for the creation of music, Lord, and harmony, and all the beauty of the earth that we see when we go outside, God. So we just thank you for rest and the special time that you've set aside to spend with us on your Sabbath day. And God, we thank you also for, as this week is ending, Lord, we're going to thank you for a new beginning as we begin a new week tomorrow. We just thank you for everything, Lord God. So, good Lord, we just pray that you go with us now as we take a break. And, Lord, may your Holy Spirit just continue to remain in our hearts as we worship you during the divine hour. In Jesus' name, amen.